Could we do our best to live a more excellent life here? Amen. Could that be what we're about? Could we learn to love one another better? And if we're able to do that, then I don't care what happens here. I don't care how many people we see turn their lives completely around or how many continue to stumble along the way. I will have said this has been a success.
Amen.
I want to close this morning with words that were found on a piece of paper in the pocket of a Confederate soldier more than 150 years ago. And though they have since been commandeered by politicians and sentimentalists, I think they contain some great wisdom. And that soldier wrote, "I ask God for strength that I might achieve. I was made weak that I might learn humbly to obey. I ask God for health that I might do greater things. I was given infirmity that I might do better things. I ask God for riches that I might be happy. I was given poverty that I might be wise. I asked God for power that I might have praise. I was given weakness that I might feel the need of God. I asked for all things that I might enjoy life. I was given life that I might enjoy all things. You see, I got nothing that I asked for, but everything I hoped for."
Amen.
That's the more excellent life. Let's pray. Your servant Paul, the man who had brought terror upon Christians in the early church, the man who was so cocky and self-assured at one point in his life that he thought he knew the way, found himself struck down at a point in his life he never expected, struck down blind, and out of that crisis he came to know you, as he'd never known you before. And look what he did. This very day, some nearly 2,000 years later, we hang on his every word when he describes so eloquently this more excellent way. Help us, Lord, this day to embrace the words given us by Paul, to put them into our daily lives, our daily decisions, our daily actions, our daily relationships, is our prayer in the name of Jesus.